Welcome to Your 20-Minute Podcast with David Brower, where we do our best to give you useful information in 20 minutes or less. Now, here's your host, five-time Voice Arts Awards nominee, David Brower.
Thanks, Alan. This is David Brower with Your 20-Minute Podcast. Our special guest from Atlanta today, Mark and Ann Lackey. They're well-known across the nation as real estate investors, three-time best-selling authors, speakers, educators, whether selling a home they just renovated, finding income property for other investors, or buying for their own portfolio, they keep busy and they get it all done while using global virtual assistants, which is a fascinating topic. And so, Mark, Ann, welcome to the show. Glad you're here.
Thank you, David. We appreciate it.
We're pleased to be with you today.
So, it's often called Hotlanta. How's your weather there?
It is hot. It is summertime, and it is cranking up.
Very humid and very hot, as normal.
As normal. Exactly right. Well, let's talk about you. When you first began, you started in the real estate business, right? What made you get into that business, and what were you doing before?
So both Mark and I came out of corporate America. I was in IT and HR, and Mark was in
transportation and relocation sales.
All right.
And we knew we needed to do something to make our money working for us versus us working for every dollar. So kind of make a long story kind of short, since we are only got 20 minutes here. We realized that rental real estate was a way that we could have passive income and provide for ourselves a retirement plan.
Nice. Very nice. And when did you start? When did you get out of corporate America and just put both feet in the water as far as real estate?
Well, we started investing 19 years ago now.
Okay.
But we kept our corporate jobs. We were investing and working on the side. Ann left her job in 2009 and I left mine in 2014.
Okay.
So we were growing our investing business. We started a property management business. And then at the end, we ended up starting a virtual assistant business. Mostly while we were working two jobs.
Good for you. What a great way to control your segue into your dream job, right?
That's true.
Yeah, that's cool. And along the way, in your spare time, you wrote four books together. Double Your Real Estate Business, Rent and Grow Rich, Robin Hood Is Not Dead, Multiply Yourself. You got some bestsellers out there, and they're all available on Kindle for $3. So I don't know why people wouldn't jump on there and get that. Have you had some good success with those books?
Oh, absolutely. Our first book called Rent and Grow Rich was how we started in passive income.
Uh-huh.
The others are kind of around virtual staff. We've actually written three more, but we haven't actually released them on the Amazon platform. We use them as kind of our business card.
Oh, nice. Very cool idea. So I assume you travel around the country promoting your wares, do you? Or is it just online, on radio? How do you get your footprint out there?
We do a lot of traveling. We do a lot of teaching and education, a lot in the real estate world because that's, you know, kind of where we're well known.
You bet.
But we branch out as well. I mean, we've been speakers to 3,000 people and, you know, business owners. Mark just had a talk with 900 business owners back in February. So
nice.
We do a lot of education because we want people to be well versed in what their options are to, you know, to grow and have more of what they want out of life.
And that's a wonderful, wonderful way to do it, I think, because it seems like more and more all the time, or it's been several years, I guess, where people are on the radio, they're on TV, and they're pitching their wares, and, hey, come buy my book, come to my seminar, and you're going to get rich in 27 hours, and here we go. And right? And it's like, oh my God, there's no silver bullet out there. You've got to take the time to get educated and talk to people that have some integrity. And it looks to me like that's how you guys roll with your business.
Yeah. And in our coaching, many times people say, hey, I want to get what you got. We want to have what you have. And well, you know, we remind them we worked multiple jobs.
Yep.
Full time. We were very successful in our corporate jobs while we continued to grow these businesses. And it is a sacrifice. It really is to get to a point of financial freedom.
Absolutely. And one of the blessing has to be, and you guys will know this better than I. But being able to do this together and be on the same page and travel together and work together and have the same mindset, I mean, I'm sure there are time to time where you want to drink decaf coffee instead of regular coffee, but it's got to be a thrill to be able to do that together.
It is. And we designed our lives when we got married to be able to do things together. And we knew in our corporate jobs we couldn't.
Right.
So we designed all of our businesses to where we both work in them. We're both very active. And we've divided up the business responsibilities by department. And whoever has the best track record, the best record, the best knowledge about a particular department heads that up and has the final say. So it allows us to divide the work up and conquer and not try to conquer each other.
That is brilliant. Brilliant. I'm looking on your website, hiresmartvas.com, and we'll talk about virtual assistants in a minute. But the first thing I noticed and was very impressed by, because you don't see this on hardly any websites, and that is your core values. And
absolutely.
Oh, my gosh. I mean, that is, talk about authenticity, transparency, integrity. That is brilliant that you put that out there. Hardly anybody does that.
Well, we are all about the law of attraction, and we want people to do business with us that are in alignment.
There you go.
We have a vision to kind of change the world in mm-hmm. a lot of ways. We're changing lives in the Philippines by providing them awesome career opportunities.
Mm-hmm.
But we're also changing U.S. business owners' lives by giving them more of the life that they want. And so, talk about transparency. We are probably way transparent.
when we speak, we're not on stage selling what we do. We're on stage sharing how we've done things and give people inspiration and give them concepts and tools that they can work with. And from that, they are attracted to us and they want to do business with us. And it's just a different methodology. Like you say, you don't see much of that.
Well, you don't. And I think more and more people these days, even though we're going, you know, we're in the world of immediate gratification and what have you done for me lately? And I'm going 128 miles an hour and I don't have time to take my kid to the park and those kinds of things. And a lot of folks take advantage of that, to be honest with you. And they're offering the silver bullet, which doesn't exist. And you guys go out there with your presentation and want to the attraction piece of that. That's got to be so refreshing to people that attend your training seminars. No wonder they're attracted to you.
Well, we do have some raving fans. And typically, I tell most of our clients that, or potential clients, that usually the first time they engage with us, it's a little scary because
sure.
you don't know what you don't know. I said, but more often than not, after people engage with us or do business with us, they're very quick to do business with us again because it's such a refreshing, for lack of a better term, authentic relationship where we really are creating these win-win alliances that work for everybody, because that's important to us.
Good for you. It should be important to all of us. And
it should.
You know, really should. So the core values, and you can see this on their website, hiresmartvas.com. Mindful, we want raving fans. Available, easy access to both these folks. Respectful, love, protect, and respect others. Team, working together. Ethics and integrity, doing the right thing. And relationships, most important overall. That should be on everybody's mind, if not their website. That is so well said. So good for you.
Well,
good
thank
for you.
You.
So when did you decide to go from, or add on, I suppose, go from being real estate magnates, for lack of a better term, to get into the virtual assistants business? How did that transpire? Where was that epiphany from?
Well, we have a property management business that grew out of our investing, and we're managing a couple hundred rental homes for our clients.
Mm-hmm.
And we have a leasing person that answers all the calls that people want to see a home that's available. And they were answering the calls. We went on vacation the first time in 7 years, and we got a text. And the text from that individual says, I've gone to lunch, I've left my keys on my desk, and I'm not coming back.
Oh, my gosh.
So from that, wake-up call, we recognize that sometimes employees will take advantage of you. Sometimes we're not getting a great result out of our employees. And we decided to start looking for staff elsewhere. And that's in how we ended up looking into the Philippines and started using virtual assistants.
Nice.
And in the beginning, it was very scary for us.
Yeah.
We hadn't done it before. We talked to some people that had done it. And, you know, so we went through the school of hard knocks to learn how to do it, hit every pitfall and every speed bump learning it. But after we had done it for about 6 months, things in our business had changed. And then we had our friends and other business owners say, hey, we were at lunch. They said, hey, you look happy again. What's different? Because we have VAs doing things for us.
And that's not the Veterans Administration, folks.
No. So Ann pulls up Skype on her phone and thrusts it across the table to our friends, business owners, and said, here, meet Teresa. And they talked to her it was out of the blue.
Yeah.
They gave the phone back to Ann and said, both of them said, if we write you a check, will you train and deliver some Teresas in about 5 weeks?
Oh, my God.
More like 3 weeks.
And
5 weeks always is 3 weeks. That's right.
Yeah. Well, it included 2 weeks of training. And so we had to find them in 3 weeks, train them for two, and then deliver them actually to their jobs because they had people that were quitting.
Yeah.
And out of that became this new business for us.
That's so awesome. I was talking to my granddaughter the other day. She works at a fast food burger joint, and she had an interview with the Chinese fast food place, and she was excited because it'd be more healthy for her and all that kind of stuff. And I said, well, if you get that job, you know, what are you going to do? How are you going to talk to your boss? Well, I'll just text him. I said, no, you won't. You need to. Unfortunately, her mother was there and backed me up, but I said, you need to do this face to face. You're very respectful to your boss, your employees. When you go in every day, why wouldn't you be respectful if you decided to move across the street? Okay. I like that. So she got the interview, got the new job, went back to tell her boss that she was going to quit. Because she was so honest up front and had done outstanding work previous, he not only gave her more hours, he gave her more money.
Wow.
And she's 15.
Wow.
And that was like, that was an amazing life changer for her. So your core values are unbelievably critical no matter where you are, what job you are, what country you're in. They're just critical, you know?
And kudos for you to helping her to see, because what we have found is most people, they end up hiring somebody they like.
Correct.
But they hire somebody that's typically not really producing and not able to focus and keep attention on the job because we're not taught how to find those kinds of people.
Right.
And so we got frustrated with the attitudes and, you know, that they'll just text.
Yeah.
And again, kudos for you for teaching that life lesson to your granddaughter.
Thanks. Yeah, it is. I mean, I don't know if it's the millennials or what it is, what stereotype you put this on, man, maybe I shouldn't, but it seems like so much of the communication now is easy, quick, short, impersonal. And how in the world can you run a successful business with that kind of environment? You know, I mean, the relationships, as you said, is above all the most important thing with your clients and your customers. And if you don't have staff trained to embrace that and be on the same page with you, man, that is just suicide.
Well, it's interesting because that we truly believe that if you have a good relationship, that kind of transcends everything else, right?
Yep, exactly.
We are a human to human business. I don't care how much tech is involved in what you do.
Yep.
The reality is we crave relationships.
That's right.
And most of our virtual assistant placements are companies that want somebody to answer the phones, answer emails, whatever type of correspondence is coming in, but to answer those calls that come in that are typically the same or very similar question day in, day out, repetitive, over and over and over and over again.
Right.
And Americans get frustrated with answering. We call it the same 7 questions all day long.
Yeah, yeah.
And so the Filipinos have grown up in an environment of serving, and they're just happy as can be to answer that phone and answer those same seven questions with a smile on their face.
Absolutely. And what that does, obviously, is frees up the business owner to do the job they built their business to do in the first place.
It absolutely does. What I was going to say, though, is while the VAs are very well trained in the Philippines for that level of service, where they lack education, which is part of what we provide, is the relationship dynamics between the client, the employer, and the VA. So they're very good at giving good customer service to the client's customers, right?
Right.
But again, that relationship. So a lot of what I do as part of my screening process, as part of my training and my ongoing HR duties is to remind the workers that they have to invest in the relationship. And then I have to remind the clients too, that you can't just have somebody off on the other side of the world and never talk to them and expect that to be rosy, right?
Yeah, these are people.
You need to invest time, energy, and effort in them, just like you would any in-house physically present person.
Right.
And so that's one of the main reasons that we have that as part of our smarter core values, is because that relationship is the cornerstone of everything else.
Well, I love your process of screening and testing, candidate presentations, training, onboarding. I mean, really doing everything you possibly can to make these VAs as relatable to a new business as possible. And because you're not throwing them in the fire, you know, you're testing them and making sure that, hey, this is the right fit for this business. The business person goes, oh, my God, where'd you find him or her, right?
Yeah. It's funny. I just got off of a call, and it was a conference call, and two of my clients happened to be on that call for a committee that we all are. And they, I couldn't stop them from talking about how awesome their people are, so we can get started for the meeting. But that's exactly what I love. Like, that's the kind of feedback I want from everybody, and we typically do.
Well, those are raving fans based on relationships, right?
Yes. And when we started this business, we looked at it initially because the pay scale in the Philippines is so great that we can offer a person at, you know, a 40-hour-a-week individual at $9 an hour that's got a 4-year degree, highly educated, will just bend over backwards to answer questions and take care of things. And we looked at it as all as a cost savings for a business. Yes, it is. At $9 an hour, because you can't find anybody for $20-$25 an hour to do those types of jobs. But what we've found out that the customer service level has increased tremendously with all of our clients. And that's what the raving was all about. It wasn't that they're saving money and making more, putting more profit in their pocket. It was about how they're able to raise the bar of service to their clients.
And that's what we're all looking for, is customer service, somebody to hear what we have in our head and respond to it in a professional, meaning, authentic way. That's just, it's brilliant. We're just about out of time. I want to make sure people can find you, and that is HireSmartVAs.com. That's Hire Smart Virtual Assistants, HireSmartVAs.com. You can learn about their process, resources, core values. It's a wonderful gift that you bring to the table, and I'm thrilled with your success because of how many people you touch along the way who obviously pay it forward and touch others.
Absolutely. David, we'd like to offer your listeners a free copy of our book, Multiply Yourself. It's one of our best-selling books.
Okay.
So if you go to the website that you provided, hiresmartvas.com/podcast, all they need to do is provide their email address, and it will be auto-delivered to them.
Awesome. That is so generous. Thank you so much. Again, that's HireSmartVAs.com/podcast, and you'll get a free book and get in touch with these people who are touching so many. It's been a thrill talking to you both. Continued success, and congratulations on coming up with core values that are so meaningful in today's world.
Thank you for having us, David.
Thank you.
We appreciate it.
Listen to your 20-minute podcast with David Brower on the go. Downloads are available on YouTube, Twitter, Facebook, iTunes, iHeartRadio, Spotify, any podcast app, and on our website at davidbrowervo.com/your20-minute podcast. Until next time, thank you for listening.